Well, we've been watching her nail live television skills, pampering one of our audience members this morning, and she knows how to handle some of the world's biggest celebs, but she's here now to talk to us all about the trends, the tips for nails this spring, summer. Please make welcome nail stylist to the stars, Leah Light. Welcome to the show. You've done manicures on a whole host of celebrities, Rita Ora, Taylor Swift, Eva Longoria, Katy Perry, Bruce Springsteen as well.
Yeah, just one nail though.
Right, one nail?
Yeah, well, he actually uses it as a pick, so
So you strengthen it?
Yeah, so I built it up with acrylic so that he could use it. So it's not particularly visually appealing, but it does a great job.
Wow. And with these celebrities, I mean, do any get really picky and really kind of difficult diva?
I've been really lucky because everybody's been super amazing that I've worked with. Some people, just like everybody, I suppose, depends on what it's for. So they might have something specific in mind that you've got to do, and you kind of just have to wing it. My kit's
But you're
massive.
Based in Auckland, aren't you?
Yeah.
Do you hop on a plane and sort of go to Hollywood and do nails?
Not Hollywood, but I have been in London and done nails over there, and I've been here a couple of times.
And, and what's the craziest thing a celebrity's ever asked you to do?
Well, I did some crazy ones on Rita Ora when I was doing her nails. So we did, they were long, we custom coloured, like every different nail was a different colour, and we did 3D nail art. So it was, they were probably the craziest I've done.
Right. Now, I've seen pictures of people who've got gems, crystals, bubbles on their nails. Mm-hmm. How did these people do anything?
Oh, wow. Yeah, how do you
I mean, it looks fantastic, but how do people do anything?
Well, you do get used to it. I mean, I've got ridiculously long nails, but you do actually get used to it. Things like that are obviously very extreme, and you wouldn't imagine they'd be doing anything too hands-on.
I imagine not a lot of piano players.
You wouldn't be doing the dishes, that's for sure.
Well, it doesn't get me out of doing the dishes.
Now, nail polishes and nails change fashion trends during the season. So what are the trends coming for spring and summer?
Well, nail art is still there, but you find that it's sort of toned down a little bit, focusing on things like negative spacing or like the geometric pattern that we just did. So something that's Yeah, so that would be a negative space. So you can see that the colour is just the black and the rest is just the natural nail, and I mean I've done quite a lot of that as well, and also the nails that we just did, which were geometric, so shape, so like a really more stylized version of nail art. Because I mean, there's definitely the pop art, and I mean you can see there that you know we've done some really straight lines and geometric.
That's our audience
patterns.
Member who you just did earlier today.
Yeah,
that's great. Would you be able to do a nail where Jono could write his lines on it?
Sheet notes. Are there other trends, nude and shapes?
Absolutely. So white is another amazing colour for spring, summer. Cobalt blue is really bright and beautiful. The naked manicure is also something really good, which is part of what I've been here for with the electric nail tool by Scholl. Just getting the natural nail in a really good condition. Yep. But then as far as shape goes, we were talking about this before about, you know, long being really in.
I'm out of fashion.
But actually, that's also still very in fashion because long is not, you know, something that's always achievable for everyday people. Mm-hmm. So a short, well-manicured nail is still highly fashionable.
And Scholl's actually put together a little bit of a gift pack for our wonderful audience member for being such a good sport. That was for getting your nails done. There you go. You can keep them in tip-top condition. Thanks so much for coming in. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.